Let us begin. Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 1st April 2017. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader, Superior Profit, a company based in Singapore. As usual, I will not take time to introduce myself. If you would like to know more about me, the company, or more importantly, how to use Superior Profit Way to invest profitably, you may visit the About Us page from our website and learn more about this. Before we begin, let's go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. Let's go through the usual topics. We will look at gold, oil, few worldwide indices, say India Nifty, and look at few forex charts also, Sing dollar, and let us look at Australia dollar and Euro USD also in this week. Then we will move to analyzing US market using SPY, QQQ, DIA, the three broad market ETFs. Before going into broad market internal analysis, sector and industry analysis using graphs, charts, and heat ranking map. We will go through few of the trades that were posted in community since our last class, and also look at potential trades for coming week. You may suggest some stocks. If we have some time, then in miscellaneous section, I would like to go through some of the ETFs with narrow spread options, run sonar on them in live market, and see if we have any chart pattern that is interesting for the coming week. Q&A is throughout the session, and you may use the Q&A panel to ask questions anytime. That was the last slide in our presentation. Let us now start with the commodities, few commodities we look at every week. Let's start with gold. I'm using TradeStation for looking at gold. On the left-hand side is the weekly chart with backdrop template, and on the right-hand side is the daily chart with hop-on template. In the last class, we had discussed that if price came down from a memory line, then we could potentially take a short trade right at this point using stretch release signal. And let me switch the template to the advanced hop-on template, so that we can see the stretch release. The stretch release actually happened on this yellow candle. So a swing trader could have taken a bounce short trade or box short trade at the close of this yellow candle. Whereas an alert trader could have entered the trade even before that using real-time Q fine-tune chart. And since then, gold has come down at the right edge of the chart. It is resting right on top of the cyan direction line. The candle shape is bearish. So if somebody had entered a short trade, some profit might have been booked or not booked, but one will be careful if price reverses and make sure that so far the profitable trade doesn't turn into losing trade. In the weekly chart, it seems to be creating a false upside breakout. It tried to go above the memory resistance line and then come down. This was the chart pattern that we analyzed last week and suggested a potential short trade, and re-emphasizing that we will not try to take a long trade at this point when price was already at upper boundary. Let's look at USO. Here, last week we discussed the pattern was somewhat reversing, opposite to that of gold. Here price came down and then we watched the memory support line in both weekly and daily and suggested that we might take a long trade on Monday. This yellow candle was Monday's candle, provided price went above early range high. And since then price has gone up, and whether it was taken as a day trade on Monday's candle or taken as a swing trade, both of these trades have exited with sizable profit. I had actually posted the two potential day trades that we discussed in last week in the community, and let us go through those charts to see exactly how the trades could be entered and exited. If we go to community, inter-community, I have detailed the way the two trades could have been entered and exited based on the discussion we had in last week's market roundup, and here are the two charts. This chart is for US oil, 5-minute chart using fine-tuned template. For US oil on Friday, here we decided to take a long trade on Monday if price went above early range high. On Monday, once the market opened, early range high and low were formed, and when early range high was broken, we would have taken the long trade, put stop just below early range low, and start booking profit once the risk distance was covered. So that could be at this red line, that is previous day's low, or it could be at the other significant pivot levels, intraday pivot levels. So in this case, clearly the profit acquired was more than the risk taken. So a day trader would have booked profit, and a swing trader could use this technique for precision entry of the long USO position, might have booked some profit around this place and then hold the remaining position for next day. This was also a gap long opportunity. In our education center, in books menu, books page, there is a separate book dedicated to gap day trading. Gap day trading means for the days where market opens, like in this case, below last day's low, then there is an imbalance in the market, and we sometimes see if market is continuing in the direction of the imbalance or reversing to fill the gap. In this case, we saw that after the gap opened, early range high and low were formed, and then price actually went up. So gap trading technique says that if that is the case, take a long position, put a stop below early range low, and book profit when the risk distance is covered or significant pivot levels are hit. So this was a case where we could have traded USO as a day trade in two different ways. One is based on gap day trade, and also based on the analysis of daily chart that we had done based on Friday's end of day. Now, if we look at the gold chart was opposite, almost opposite. Both it was so in the hop on chart when we analyzed at the end of the week, and also on Monday's market move. On Monday, US oil had opened with a gap down. However, gold had opened with a gap up. This was last day's close, and Monday price opened at this point, creating a gap up. It also opened substantially above Friday's high. So again, using gap day trade technique, we wait for the early range high and the low to be formed, and then take a short as early range low is broken, put stop at early range high, and start booking profit either when the risk distance is covered or at significant pivot levels. So gold short day trade on Monday could be taken as a gap day trade. It could also be taken based on the analysis that we had done on Friday's chart. When we enter swing trading in this way using fine-tuned template, then we are in effect accepting very less risk, that is the distance between these two pivot levels, early range high and low, whereas we are expecting profit to be much larger because profit is going to be booked in the daily time scale, whereas we are taking risk in a 5-minute chart time scale. So such precision entries, when we are already anticipating a move, like in this case, can give us extremely high reward risk ratio. Let's go back to the US oil chart. Here, the day trade happened only on this yellow candle. And you can see for a swing trader, it continued to move up for several days. And when price came around 10.6, it has come to the value area and a swing trader would book profit. So now you can clearly see that the risk taken was only on a small part of this day's move. Whereas the profit happened is much more across a different, totally different time scale. Profit we are booking in swing trade in daily time scale, whereas because we used fine-tuned chart to enter the trade, precisely enter the trade, the risk taken was only on 5-minute time frame. So this works out pretty well for us when we anticipated trade and use fine-tuned template. Let's look at now India market and some forex pair. For India, we are going to look at Nifty index, Nifty futures, and we will use MetaStock for that. Nifty is a market benchmark itself, so we don't need the relative performance. At the right edge of the chart, Nifty is near upper boundary. And remember, in last week's class, we had discussed that even if we get a cyan candle, like we got in this case, on this candle, it was already too close to the upper boundary for us to try to take a trade. The reward was not good compared to the risk, and we said that an ideal trade would have, a better trade would have happened if price went up and then came down, giving us a kind of bounce or box trade signal. So no such signal has come. The cyan candle had come here, but we wouldn't take the trade because the reward risk ratio was not attractive. There is no signal at the right edge of the chart. Let's look at Sing dollar versus US dollar. Here, price came down from the magenta flow candle. Then it hit the white very slow direction line, and since then it is moving sideways. There is clearly no signal at the right edge of the chart. Interestingly, there are multiple memory resistance lines now at 1.4 to 1.419, around that level. So if price happens to come back to this area, we'll be expecting at least a temporary decline from that level. Right now, there is no trade setup. Let's look at Australia dollar versus US dollar. We had watched the memory resistance lines forming at this point earlier, and then we decided to take a short if price bounced down. That swing trade short using bear release at memory resistance worked well, more than the risk resistance had been covered by the time price came to the ascending yellow direction line. For swing short trade, an ascending line, yellow or white, acts as a support, and we always book profit. So following that discipline, profit would have been booked on this red candle. That worked out to be a profitable trade again. There is no trade at the right edge of the chart. However, if we clear the chart, we see that there was a magenta candle on Thursday. That is a potentially go with flow short candle. However, we will not take the short because we have a support memory very close to Thursday's close. So we would not like to take a position, swing trade position, based on this magenta candle. However, a day trader could have used the information to take a short trade on Friday, and that trade would have exited with profit. Let's look at Euro USD. And for that, I will first go back to our community and refer to the quiz that was posted. Under community, there is a quiz playground. Under quiz playground, few days ago, I had posted a quiz. Let me go to the chart as of the quiz time. This was how the chart was looking like at that time. Euro USD, and the question I had asked in the quiz that if you had to take a trade, will you take a long trade or a short trade? Based on this backdrop template weekly on the left and hop on template daily on the right. Could you type your answer please in the Q&A panel? Based on the chart that is in front of you, if you had to take a trade, will you take a long trade or a short trade? Yes, thank you. Yes, very right, short and Enamul says short, Terry says short, and headwind, very good. Headwind, like all the other trade setups, have a checklist. All we needed to do is to check if the checklist is applicable, and the checklist says for a weekly candle, it has to be bearish shape or bearish color. In this case, it was not bearish color, that is magenta, not magenta. However, it had very clear bearish shape. So the weekly condition was matched. In the daily chart, the condition says that we should have a bearish headwind signal. The diamond red signal had come, and it also should have a bearish shape candle. A solid candle is bearish. So both these conditions were fulfilled, and we needed to see if the reward risk is acceptable. So if somebody took the short trade, stop will be just above recent high, and one could expect to book profit near value area around the yellow, at that time ascending direction line, and we see acceptable reward risk ratio, and it could be taken as a headwind short signal. Other than the headwind signal itself, there were a few more bearish indications. One is that it was forming a double top at a high watermark level. and price tried to go above it and immediately came down, creating a false upside breakout. That is also bearish in superior profit way. And on top of that, price was also reversing down from the white, that is very slow direction line. So there were many bearish signals, and if we had to take a trade, we would have taken a short trade. And let's see how the trade played out. In a few days since we posted it, we saw that it came, let me clear the arrows. We saw price came down. The high created by the bearish headwind was never breached. The stop loss was not touched. Instead, more than risk distance was covered. And as of this chart, profit could already be booked. We can look at Euro USD as of today, whether it has gone down or up, I don't remember, but one point I want to again reinforce that for swing trading, it has a welcome period. And if we take a trade, we have to decide in superior profit way, where is our stop? In this case, just above reset high. Where is our profit target? It could be either if the risk distance is covered or at the next support line. Once the risk distance is covered, we'll make sure that a profitable trade doesn't turn into a losing trade, as was done in this case. Having said that, let's look at Euro USD today. And we see that Euro USD fell even more. It hit the yellow direction line. So at yellow direction line, we, with discipline, must have booked some profit and put a trailing stop in a way using queue protection signal that the entire trade is risk-free from now onward. Now we also see there are multiple support lines coming. So those may be points for additional profit booking, but we must have booked some profit at the yellow line where much more, probably double the risk amount, was already covered. So this trade also worked out perfectly as expected based on the beautiful headwind bearish signal. I'm looking at the Q&A also. There is a question from Enamol. How can I change session time for Australia, UK, USA market in Meta stock? For any market, we can go to the tools, indicator builder. If you type C, it will go to the first Q indicator. One is for benchmark. So for forex trading, we don't need to use benchmark, but for stock trading, we can set the benchmark with respect to what the relative performance will be calculated. So right now I can see that it is setting it to India benchmark index. For USA market, we'll set it to SPY. So you can just type the benchmark symbol here. Please make sure that you have access to data for the benchmark symbol you are using. How to check that? You can just try to plot the symbol in MetaStock. If you are able to plot the symbol in MetaStock, you can use it as a benchmark. That is the general guideline. For session, you see the third indicator, just edit it and set the session start hour minute and session end hour minute in the exchange time zone. So this is for India market again. So it starts at 9:15 a.m. and closes at 3:30 p.m. That's how it is set. You can also, for the regularly used markets, you can go to our website, go to contact FAQ and search for market specific, or you could scroll down as well. You see an article posted in FAQ, country market specific setup files for Q Global, and you will see for multiple stock trading markets, the files are already provided. Australia, India, Singapore, China, Japan, USA, etc. So what I have done, I have put them in my start, in my Windows, Windows 10, I think. So when I want to change country, then I can just click on this and it will be setting benchmark and session for those countries. So those are few ways you can change the session and the benchmark parameters. By the way, session benchmark are the only two parameters that we need to set. That too, if we are trading in multiple markets. If not, we just set it for once and then forget it, run, keep on using queue system happily. Let's go back to the chart. So this was euro. Oh, we had a profitable euro USD bearish headwind short trade. Now let's look at the three US market ETFs. For that, we'll use TradeStation. We see from the weekly chart backdrop template that SPY opened down on Monday, but then reversed to close higher than previous week's close. And the same pattern we can see from daily chart. In daily chart, we see that since the bearish headwind formed, price couldn't breach that high anymore. A watermark high level has formed, and it has also created lower high and lower low. So now if price tilts down from the current price level, we'll have a very clear go with flow short signal, because I can see that though price reversed back last week, the backdrop color remains magenta. So if on Monday or Tuesday price tilts down, either from the value area at current price level or probably go to the memory resistance and tilts down, it could give a potential go with flow short trade setup. You may watch for that. Note that Friday's candle was very narrow range and it had a bearish shape. The last few days price had gone up, but two of the days, this is Friday, right? So Thursday, Wednesday, the activity was extremely small. And clearly the red down days, activity color red means those are down days. The red down days are with much higher activity or volume than the green up days for SPY. If we go to Dow Jones Industrial Average, then we see a similar pattern is playing out. In the weekly, the price opened lower but covered the gap. It closed above last week's close. In daily chart, again, the bearish headwind high has not been breached. A watermark high level has formed. It is already in downtrend, creating lower high and lower low. Price is at value area. So again, if price tilts down, we may have a go with flow short opportunity on Monday. Weekly is already magenta. So if price goes down on Monday, weekly will remain magenta. We clearly see that Dow Jones Industrial Average is weaker than SPY because the relative performance is quite sharply tilting down. And if we look at activity here, we see the up days are even with less volume compared to SPY, and the red bars are much higher. That is, the down days are with higher activity. That is bearish in terms of activity study. Now, of the three ETFs, NASDAQ QQQ had been strongest earlier, and that same pattern is continuing. Here, price came back. This is the only symbol of the three ETFs that could go above the bearish headwind symbol and also breached the watermark high level. However, on Friday's chart, we see that it barely breached and came down with a bearish shape candle with relatively high activity. not very high, high activity. Thick lines indicate high. Very high would have a green or a cyan dot, but it came down with high activity with a bearish shape. It is at a double top. So on Monday, if price came down with a bear release signal, stretch release signal, then it could potentially give us a very low risk box short trade. I see in this case, weekly is already yellow. So if price comes down, it will remain yellow or may become magenta. So the weekly will confirm the signal in the day trade, in the daily chart, and we might have a potential short trade in QQQ. So we saw that there is a potential for a short forming in all the three ETFs. In SPY and DIA, it could be go with flow short. And in case of QQQ, it would be box short using stretch release signal. Let's now move to broad market sector and industry analysis. For that, I will go through the charts that I have already created. I see that there is a question on session setting for Forex trading. Now for Forex, the guideline is that at least that's my way of trading. I use the session setting for the most active period. So if I am trading Euro USD, then I would like to set my session start and session end to New York London overlap time. Similarly, if somebody is trading Japanese yen and British pound, they may set the session end and start to the Japan London overlap period. That is my way of trading Forex, trading only in the most active periods of the pairs. This is more clear for the major pairs. For non-major pairs, it becomes more difficult. You may look at the pairs in real-time time frame and see where most active periods are and set the session start and end time to those times. But for major pairs, the times are pretty clear. Like for Euro USD, GBP USD, it will be the London New York overlap session. Okay, this is the broad market study using NASDAQ composite index on the left hand side and NYSE composite index on the right hand side. On top of that, we are also plotting three market internals, new high low, number of stocks making new high minus number of stockings new low, advance decline, number of stocks advancing minus number of stocks declining, that is total number, and up down volume, volume of all stocks going up minus volume of all stocks going down. We see the same pattern in the composite indices that we saw in the ETFs, that is NASDAQ index opened lower, but by Friday it has recovered all the loss and in fact opened at the high of the week. NYSE index also opened lower and by the end of the week recovered all the loss and closed above last week's close, though not as high as NASDAQ. So here also we see the same pattern that NASDAQ is stronger than NYSE, as we saw QQQ stronger than SPY. Now in terms of the internals, they continue to be weak, meaning they have not been able to reach the earlier peaks for any of the market internals. In terms of closing positive or negative, we see that out of the six internals, five of them actually closed positive. Only one, that is up down volume for NYSE, closed negative. Magenta is negative And magenta also indicates it went down compared to last week. So other than this internal, which closed negative and declined relative to previous week, all the other five internals closed positive. So overall, we can say, as far as the exact past week is concerned, the broad market internals are bullish. However, overall, they continue to remain weak, not able to breach earlier highs. But the composites themselves are strong. We finally have to trade based on the composites move. That's how we can make money. So we don't have any bearish opportunity right now looking at the composites. However, remember, this is weekly chart. This is used for more longer term trading. As we saw in the ETF charts, there are potential swing trade opportunities, possible opportunities that may come next week on the short side. I see a question on what is the most active time for USD INR. You may plot it on the fine-tune chart and find out. This is not a major pair. I don't track all the pairs available in the forex market. Best way is to just plot it on the chart and see the active period. And if you are trading that pair, I suggest trade only in the active period. Let's go to sector analysis. And here we see the flip-flops are clearly continuing. We have been mentioning it for several weeks now. If you remember last week's sector chart, and in the sector chart, we look at 10 sectors across three different time periods. The red bar indicates previous week, the blue bar 5 days prior to that, and the green bar 10 days prior to blue bar. So together they constitute 20 days or about 1 month of movement. If you remember last week's data, most of the sectors ended negative except one. That one was utility. Utility ended positive last week. Whereas in this chart, this week's graph, we see the reverse, almost the reverse. Most of the sectors ended positive. The red bar coming to the right hand side, whereas utility actually turned negative. In this case, telecom also turned negative. So this flip-flop is very much continuing at sector level, 1 week up and other week down. We will see the same pattern coming up in industry analysis as well. In case of the five best performing industries, there is no clear pattern between advancing industries. Coal added to last week's gain. Coal is the only industry group I saw among the top performing industries that were that was positive last week and also this week positive by a sizable margin, 6.6. And overall, the best performing industries gained by larger percentage than worst performing industries declines. So we can see the gains were 6.6, 4.8, 4.5, from 3.3 to 6.6, high percentage gain for the best performing industries. But if we go to the declining industries this week, we can see the percentages are lower, declined by 1% to 2.8%. In last week, the numbers were opposite. The declines were bigger than the advances. So again, here we see flip-flop. Renewable energy is the one that continues to perform poorly week after week, month after month. And if we see the other few industry groups, we see that multi-utility distillers, and electricity. Now they are worst performing industry, but they were among the best performers 1 week ago. This again shows the flip-flop. If we see the industries with biggest rank improvement, this is where the flip-flop is stunningly visible, because all the 10 biggest rank improvers, starting from industrial metal mining to aluminium, all of them exactly matches the worst performing industries 1 week ago. So these 10 that had the biggest rank improvement in this week, industrial metal to aluminium, to banks, to automobile parts, to business training, general mining, they gained rank, the top rank gainer. However, last week they were among the worst performers, exact match industry to industry. Showing that one week, the big players are buying some stocks, and the next week in the same industry, they are selling. There is no clear conviction in terms of sector or industry in this market. Now, in terms of the biggest decliners, we can see that 6 of the biggest 10 decliners were the exact same industries that were best performers 1 week ago. Again, showing the flip-flop, starting from gold mining to electricity to utility. Remember, utility is the only, not only, utility and telecom are the two sectors that are down this week, whereas last week utility was going up strongly. Many of the industry groups with rank declines you see are conservative ones, like electricity, utility again, gas distribution. So we see this pattern again, that sometimes the conservative sectors industries are going up, sometimes they are going down. So the flip-flop continues. We don't see any clear direction in the sectors or industries. Those were the broad market sector and industry analysis graphs for this week. So we have covered gold, oil, Nifty, few forex symbols, broad market sector and industry analysis. Let us now go through some of the trades from our community since last week. We have already gone through Euro USD or Aussie USD, gold and oil trade. Let's see if we can find some more trade that we shared since last week's class. So in our community, we can go to topics. Let's look at this post. I updated this post. It was on an Indian Bank of India. I shared it exactly 1 month ago on March 1 in Trade Ideas, the public forum. And at that time, this is how the chart looked like. This is a line chart, weekly chart, weekly interval that we use for long-term investment analysis. And I noticed that it has fallen a lot because this is weekly chart. However, then it stabilized and started to go up. So when I posted the idea, I saw that even if we enter at this point, there is some distance to the next weekly resistance line. We could book some profit by that time and let profit run on the remaining position, making sure that the entire trade is risk-free from that point onward. This is the typical superior profit way. The at-a-glance chart looked like this. This was found using Sonar, that is Q Explorer, intraday basis. So I just ran it during the market hours, not near market close. And this is how the chart looked like. So based on this chart, do you see any standard superior profit trade setup? Please type your answer in the Q&A panel. Do you see any standard swing trade setup based on this at a glance template? Yes, thank you. Thank you, Terry. Yes, clear. Go with flow long, because price had already created higher high and higher low. At the right edge, price tilted up, making a cyan candle, flow color cyan, that is a potential go with flow long opportunity. Price was also being supported by memory support line, relative performance tilted up. And if we had taken a long position at this price level and put the profit target to upper boundary, stop to just below recent low, we would have acceptable reward risk ratio, profit higher than potential loss, that met all the conditions on daily chart and weekly chart. For go with flow, only condition is that the backdrop color has to be cyan or bullish, that was also met. So this was a clear go with flow long setup, but remember I told I ran Sonar as of intraday. So anyway, I shared it. Our guideline is that we need to wait for a swing trade near market close before taking the trade. But remember, this was not posted as swing trade only. It was also a long-term investment. So based on the investor's view of this company and also banking companies, other banking companies in India market, one could have taken a long position. Let's see how the trade played out. And this is the chart I just snapped today based on market close of Friday. This is a mixed template. I just added the protection, the Q protection stop loss level on hop-up template. You see, when I posted the trade idea, it was on this day. It was on intraday basis. At that time, the candle was not having an upper tail, but by the end of the day, you can see that price came down. So if somebody was analyzing it by the end of the day, near market close, India market close, they will not be entering a trade on this bar because it is not meeting all the go with flow long requirements. But if a long-term investor had already entered, then the stop loss, one way to put stop loss will be just below recent low using this Q protection signal. And we see that that protection level was never hit. Instead, price went up, hit upper boundary, and now hit the memory resistance line also at the high of Friday's candle. So this was what we planned for initially when we shared the trade, that we could take a low risk entry, book some profit when the next memory resistance or upper boundary is hit, and book some profit and put stop in a way that the entire trade is risk free. So I have discussed two ways of booking partial profit. We could book 2/3 and put 1/3 at the original stop. Or if we book half profit, then we could put trailing stop using the Q protection signal or other combinations. But these are two very simplistic combinations. Book 2/3 or book half of position when initial target is reached and let profit continue on the remaining position, either using the Q protection level or leave stop at the original stop level. So this trade also worked out as per plan, and we book profit in this trade. Let's see if there was any other trade posted. Bank of America, AUD/USD, we have seen. EURUSD, we have seen. US oil, gold, we have seen. Okay, let's look at scissors. I had posted this in Trade Ideas again, publicly accessible forum. And let's look at the snapshot when I posted it. Looking at this chart, do you think there is a standard superior profit trade setup? Caesars Entertainment, a gambling stock, casino company. Not gambling stock in the meaning not, we are not gambling in this forum, superior profit way. It just happens to be a gambling company. Looking at this chart, do you see any standard superior profit trade setup? Please type your answer in the Q&A panel. Yes, wait for next candidate. If we apply the checklist, thanks Enamu. If we apply the checklist, our standard checklist, let's look at weekly. It is bearish, magenta. On daily, it came down from a higher high, making a resistance memory. So, higher high was here. At the right edge, we already have a lower high. Lower low is not there yet. If price broke below this support memory, then a lower low will also start and we could have shorted. But because the support memory was just below this candle's close, we are not going to initiate a short trade. We are very respectful of the memory lines. Of all the signals, memory lines are very effective support resistance lines that may be drawn from few days back to few years back automatically. And this always turns out to be a good decision not to ignore the memory support resistance. And if we look at the subsequent charts, we see that the memory support was not broken. This was the magenta candle when the post was initially shared. Next day also, close happened above memory. Subsequent day also, close happened above memory. At that time, I mentioned that because the memory is holding, we are not going to take the trade anymore. If we look at Caesar today, let's look at the chart. We are using TradeStation. We can see that the memory support was not broken as of today. So it was good decision not to take a short when price didn't break the memory support, and this is always a good decision in superior profit way. Let's go back to community and see if any other trade was posted. US Steel, don't remember if we covered it last week. Let's go through it. Okay, when the trade was first shared, can you identify any superior profit and standard trade setup based on this at a glance chart? This is US Steel X, the symbol is X. And of course it is written already here. Yes, bullish headwind had come. And for the, taking a bullish headwind trade, long trade, the requirement is weekly has to be either cyan or candle shape has to be bullish, hollow. In this case, the candle shape in weekly was hollow, so that was all right. And we have to see the reward risk level. The risk could have been around this price and potential reward profit could be booked at the memory resistance level. So we had acceptable reward risk. We also saw there was a watermark level from which price was reversing. So it gave us a potential long opportunity. And when I posted this, I don't know if I shared that in the text. At that time, multiple stocks in similar industry groups were bullish. After dropping somewhat, X was one of them. Let's look at X today. There is no follow-up in this forum. We see here that after the bullish headwind signal, price went up. Didn't come back to the low again. The bullish headwinds and bearish headwind signals also work pretty well. So we are always respectful of that also. So in this case, it worked well so far. It has moved up somewhat. On Friday, it opened with somewhat indecisive, somewhat bullish candle. We'll have to see if it goes up. If it tilts down from the memory line, of course, we will book profit by that time. We will also be careful of the yellow line and see if price is going to tilt down from there. If price comes to the yellow line, we can also book profit there. I think we'll have almost same as, maybe slightly less than risk amount, but almost same. So we could make sure that the trade doesn't turn into a losing trade if the yellow line is hit, maybe Monday or Tuesday. Let's go back to the community. Gold USO early range breakout. Okay, I think those were the recent trades. We had already covered JP Morgan and Bank of America, etc. earlier. So one thing you can see that most of our trades, sometimes 80-90%, sometimes 70%, 80% trades are closing at initial profit target, and less trades are getting stopped out. However, some trades do get stopped out. I took a webinar recently and explained how with even 60 to 70% success rate, we can have very high profit by the end of the year. Have any of you gone through those webinars? Can you type? If not, I will like to share some interesting data, mathematical data. In Superior Profit Way, we only work with objective data. So I am asking, have you gone through that webinar? Any of you? How to make 60 to 70% profit, annual profit on total capital by risking only 2% in each trade. Okay, then let me share some very surprising, you may say, surprising mathematical data. So I took three different scenarios. All of these are for swing trading and using stop. So I see sometimes traders are attracted towards high risk instruments like out of the money option or even forex or even futures with high leverage, trying to make high profit. However, if we see this simple calculation, we will see that if we have a robust system, like your system say, and have very clear guideline of entry exit, then we can make substantial profit trading stop, taking low risk. So these are three scenarios that I took. In one case, a swing trader is taking 10 trades per month. In second case, 5, and third case, 10 trades again. Now these are not unrealistic. 5 trades a month means only about 1 trade a week. Or for 10 trades, it's only about 2 trades a week. Nothing high, not very aggressively high number for a swing trader. Now for stock trading, I assume the risk taken in each trade is only 2% of total capital. Again, very conservative number, not risking much in each trade. So exact amount will depend on the capital. For $100 total capital, it will be only $2 risk in each trade. $1,000, it will be 20, so on and so forth. Now, if you saw all the trades shared in community, discussed in quiz playground and webinars, etc., in Superior Profit Way, we like to take a trade where our target is at least as much as the risk. So if we are taking 2% risk, we know that if the trade is profitable, we will get at least 2% profit as well. So this is also a very fair assumption in Superior Profit Way, the way we take the trades. Now the important parameter to look for is what is the achievable success rate. Can we get 60% success rate? That is 6 out of 10 trades. Can we make profit? Now, if you think of it, if we just simply coin toss, closing our eyes and take a large number of trades, as per statistics, 5 trades will make profit, 5 trades will make loss. Assuming a totally random market and not looking at chart, not looking at sector, industry, broad market. But in Superior Profit Way, we don't close our eyes and take trades. We do look at broad market, sector, industry, and very importantly, of course, the Q charts. So having a slight edge, say 6 out of 10 instead of 5 out of 10 is very realistic. And if you are following the trades in our community, you will see 70% success rate is also achievable very much. Would you agree with that? Please type your comment in the Q&A for those who are following the trades in community, including the ones shared this week. And of course, the trade ideas, quiz, these are all public forum. Anybody can see the trades. Do you agree that using our technique, we can get 70% or 60% success rate consistently? Yes, so Enamel says yes, yes. Anybody actually can validate that, the trades in Superior Profit, we are very proud that we share the trades publicly. We don't hide behind assumptions, all the trades are shared. Now, see what happened next. It's all pure mathematics. I assumed a first case, review period of 1 month, because 10 number is a round number. For second period, I assume 2 month review period to make this 5 into 10. Third case again, 10 trades, so 1 month. So in first case, after 1 month, what is our net profit? 6 out of 10 profitable, so 6 multiplied by 2 profit, and 4 trades losing, so minus 4 multiplied by 2. So net result is, after 1 month, in case 1, we have 4% profit. So if we annualize it, we have 48% profit at the end of 1 year. In second case, to simplify, I assume 2 month period, so that 5 trade per month becomes total 10, 70% success rate. So we have 7 multiplied by 2, so much profit, 3 trades losing, so 3 multiplied by 2 loss, so 8% loss in 2 months. So again, in a year, same 48% profit. So you see, simply increasing our hit rate or success rate by 10% from 60 to 70, we can take only half the trades, not 10, but 5, and get the same amount of profit. So what happens if we get 70% success rate and take 10 trades per month? It's not very high, about 2 per week. Then we see that our annualized return on total capital, very important, on total capital, not on partial capital, is becoming 96%. And there is no ambiguity, there is no confusion, subjectivity in this calculation. It is pure mathematics. Everything is in our control. Number of trades we take, we can easily take somewhere between 5 to 10 at least per month. Let's say somewhere between 5 to 10. How much to risk in a trade is in our control. In our way, we don't take a trade unless reward is comparable to risk. So third parameter is in our control. Only thing we needed to see is, are we able to get 60 to 70% success rate? And the result is there in our forum, month after month and for a few years now. It is very much achievable. So this shows that we really don't have to go for risky instruments like Forex and even day trading for that matter, for getting higher profit. Swing trading stock and only risking 2% in each trade is good enough. Of course, there is a point of trading style. If somebody is more attracted or more effective in day trading, then fine, let them do day trading. And of course, long-term investors can do very well. And swing traders can do very well also with very reasonable success rate, as this calculation shows. Interesting, no? Interesting, and I think it's mathematical, so there is no ambiguity in this calculation. So if you have not gone through this video, I suggest you go through the entire video. In that video, I shared the mathematical calculation. But then I went through all the trades taken in a forum, not the trade ideas forum. There the data are already available to public. There was another forum, Signals forum, that was set up exactly 2 months ago. And in those 2 months, 11 trades were taken. Remember one of the scenarios where I assumed 10 trades for 2 months. So in this case, exactly 11 trades were taken in those 2 months, nothing excessive, all swing trades, in this forum. USA stock ETF option signal, 11 trades, 8 trades exited with profit, 3 trades exited with stop loss. So that was more than 7% success rate. And therefore, trading stocks, if we analyze, we'll get 48% profit at least. The video you can look at by going to the YouTube channel, and it is under this collection, APAC Online Summit. This was following up on the recent MetaStock APAC Online Summit where we participated, and this is the video. I think it's a very interesting video, and you will see all the 11 trades, whether they made profit or loss. I explained exactly how I entered and exited. So you may think about it and consider whether you would like to choose the instrument of Forex futures or stock. You may consider the mathematical basis before deciding that. Also, if you have not done that, again, I strongly suggest you go to the education book page and read this book, Secret of Successful Traders, My Experience. I have explained several aspects of trading, not only technical, but also how an ambiguity helps, how to decide, or at least how I decided which instrument to trade and which trading style to adopt, day trading, long term, or swing trading. Again, different people may have different affinity, but reading another trader's experience is helpful. You may refer to this book for that. Let's now go to our what I told I will do for miscellaneous section. Let's go through BlackBerry chart, and then there is some interesting things that we can observe from BlackBerry chart, and then run Sonar in real life and try to find some good pattern in ETFs. So let's go to TradeStation, open BlackBerry. Now, BlackBerry had earnings on Friday. Friday, that may be Thursday after market close. So Friday, the effect was on the market on Friday. On Friday, we see that it opened with a gap up. Went very much high. In few interesting things I observed, it closed below the memory resistance line. Yet another reason we keep a close eye on that. Now, if we look at the weekly chart, you will see price hit exactly the watermark high level and reversed from there. So it could be traded as a day trade in different ways. Remember, in swing trading, if we are using stock, we are not going to hold a position in BlackBerry through the earnings. So if we had taken a go with flow short trade based on this magenta candle, it didn't hit the stop that would be above recent high. It might not have reached the target also. So it will have some profit maybe, but we will exit it at close of market on Thursday. We'll not risk holding it through the earnings because that is gambling. We don't do that in superior profit way. But once the stock opened with a gap up, this is a clear gap up. So now we can take a day trade. So let's move to fine tune real time chart and see how we could take that. And remember, we were aware of the memory resistance and also aware of the watermark high just above $8 price level. So let's now go to fine-tune template. I just want to see one chart. And in TradeStation, we have hotkeys. So we can just press some hotkey and it will come up. Now, if we are taking day trade, then we can take with weekly options. Those are extremely profitable. And because it happened to be Friday, there was only few hours. That's only one day in the beginning of the day, few hours after entering the position. those options will go up or down very, very fast. So how could that be traded in different ways? And as a day trader, one needs to be flexible to take both long and short trade, just as is the case of swing trading also. Long-term investors may take only long trade, that is fine, but swing trader and certainly day traders need to be flexible. So we had a clear, very large gap open. This was Thursday's close, the magenta line. Friday's open, the blue line. It had a gap, and this was last day's high, the green line. So clearly it opened above the last day's high. Then the early range high and the early range low formed. Early range low formed. And when the price went above early range high, we could take a gap long trade. And if it is a day trade, we will use weekly option, which happened to be just daily expiry, that was Friday. And this move would give very high profit. From the early range high to the high of the day will give very high profit. So that would be a profitable gap long trade in the long direction, in the buy direction, using call option or stock. Now remember, there was a high watermark level in the weekly chart around $8 price level. So that would be exactly around here, around here. So when price went to that level, then we will be watching out, right? If we took a long position as early range breakout trade, that is also a gap day trade here, we will watch out and we will actually book profit at the very top. For a day trader, we need to be aware of the significant resistance support. We'll book profit very promptly at this level and then watch out for a short trade. What will be the setup? We have to wait for the bear release, the magenta signal to come in, and then we could take a short trade at this price level. How will the risk reward work out? Short will be around here. Stop loss will be just above the day's high. And as soon as risk distance is covered, we could book profit, or once a significant pivot level is reached, we could book profit. So this was an interesting case where we could use the move related to earnings, took a day trade in the long direction, keep an eye on the watermark level, book profit, and also reverse the trade in the short direction and book profit again. This kind of trading is very common in superior profit way. If you remember the gold chart and the USO chart that we covered in last weekly market roundup, and then we traded it as a day trade on Monday, you saw that exact same way we anticipated the move in those cases using memory support resistance and then took the trade. And in this case, we anticipated the move at the high watermark level and took the trade in the short direction. There is a question, is the short on red candle? No, in day trading, in superior profit way, we use totally different indicator and entry and exit techniques compared to swing trading. If we remember the going flow long short trades on daily chart, then we were waiting for magenta candle or cyan candle for going flow short and long respectively. For day trade, we are using zero lag indicators. So all these pivot levels have no lag. They are either there or not there. Price is either breaking them or not breaking them. So for early range breakout, and gap trade is one kind of early range breakout, we just take the trade when the level is broken. The other way we enter the trade is reversal trade, because the stretch release is very fast. So the stretch release happened on this candle. We will not wait for the red candle to enter the short. Actually, the other systems, I see many traders use the same chart for swing trading and day trading, simply changing interval from daily to 30 minute, 5 minute, etc. I am not favoring that. I think for day trading, we need to be very fast, and therefore we use zero lag indicator. So we will be entering short based on bear release, but we will not take the trade on every bear release or bull release, right? We are already deciding based on the daily chart that there is a significant resistance at $8 something. So once price comes there, then we will be looking for a bear release to take the short. So sometimes I see people opening charts, even Q charts, and thinking of taking trade at every bear release, bull release. That is not the superior profit way. In superior profit way, we differentiate between two things. One is identifying the trade and one is entering the trade. One way to identify is look at daily chart to decide the trade direction. Example, the USO example we took, also gold. These are the two examples we saw where we use the memory resistance support line to decide on the direction and then use fine-tune chart to actually enter. The decision, our trade identification was done based on daily chart, in this case, support resistance memory line. Second way is to use some real-time service. I use Zenith. In Zenith, we can look for the stocks that are best performer or worst performer in the very beginning, soon after market open. So top or worst performer or liquid stocks. I'm referring to only liquid stocks, no penny stocks, etc. Top and bottom performers. And if you see multiple top performers in same industry or worst performers in same industry, then plot them in fine tune and take a early range breakout trade in one of them. So if we are going to trade from the stronger ones, I mean the top, choose a stock from the top performer, then take a early range breakout long trade and choose the stock that is strongest on fine tune chart. And if we are taking a trade from the worst performers, then take a early range breakout short trade and choose the weakest one. That is the second way. One is daily chart, one is Zenith. And the third way is if you are regularly tracking a number of symbols. So for example, sometimes I look at SPY, QQQ and DIA, they are related, right? If you see that you are tracking regularly, you have some feeling of the symbols regularly for day trading. And then if you are going to short the weakest of them. If you are going to long the strongest of them. The third approach could be followed for futures trading also, that is E-mini, S&P 500, NASDAQ, and Dow Jones. The symbols will be ES, NQ, and YM for future symbols, respective future symbols. So these are the three guideline ways. You can combine them and find new ways. But I strongly suggest at least superior profit way is not just to open fine-tune chart and start trading, day trade, long, short direction. Actually, if we go to the result page from our website, you will see when we first started the community, we tabulated all the results. These were the only trades that were posted in community in those months. January 2015, 12 out of 14 trades were profitable. February, 10 out of 11 were profitable. March, 5 out of 5 were profitable. And April, 7 out of 7. So we didn't post excessively large number of trades, very reasonable number of trades, all swing trades. In this case, these were using only call or put options. That's why you see the percentages are very high. Using stock, it will not be so high, but doesn't matter. As we saw, for stock traders, risking only 2%, we can get substantial profit. Of course, with in-the-money option also, we could get high profit, like in these examples, provided the options have liquid, stocks have liquid options. Okay, Yeah, we are already at 1 hour 30 minute point, but let me quickly go to the registration platform and run Sonar as I promised on a list of ETF symbols. So in registration, we have radar where we can drop any symbol list that we have. So I have a list where some of the ETFs with narrow spread options. I have created that list. So if I drop it, it will go through all of them and then show me whether there is a go with flow trend following, headwind, reversal, bounce, exertion based trade, or using the stretch release signal. Where is stretch release? Using the stretch release signal, we could look for box trade. And it does the calculation and shows up the data. So I can see there is a potential trade in XLP or EWJ. By the way, EWJ is a Japan country related ETF. It may be very bouncy, so let's look at it. It may not be ideal for swing trading. Let's look at EWJ. And I want to look at it through at a glance, that is weekly, daily. So let me get back to that. On the left-hand side is backdrop using weekly. On the right-hand side is hop on using daily. So EWJ, you can see on the daily chart, is very bouncy, gap up, gap down between the days. It's not very safe for swing traders. So I'm not suggesting that. I just found it out from Sonar because it was having a magenta candle. And you notice again how using the memory support line, when price opened near the memory support and started going up, one could switch to fine-tune template and take a day trade. So if we move to the fine-tune template for this stock, let's see, we had a big gap down. Thursday's close was at this magenta level. Friday's open was at the blue line. Soon after that, early range high and low were formed. When the early range high was broken, we will take a long trade, early range breakout trade, put stop at the early range low and book profit at significant pivot levels or once this distance, risk distance was covered. So this was again a profitable trade. And you can see if we follow superior profit way, whether day trading, swing trading, and of course, long-term investment also, we have high enough success rate to get large annual profit, provided we are disciplined in following superior profit way. So this happened to be a gap long day trade also. And again, another example where we could use the memory support line in daily to identify the trade and enter the trade on 5 minute chart. Let's go back to hop on template and look at the other symbol that came up in Sonar, that is XLP. Let's look at XLP. Now, looking at this chart at a glance, do you see any trading opportunity in superior profit way? Please type your answer in Q&A. Yes, in MetaStock, Enamel says, can you use MetaStock? Yes, MetaStock also will show the exact same chart. Let me go to MetaStock for XLP. Meanwhile, you can start answering this question. Let's go to MetaStock, close this chart, open XLP with at a glance. And you have probably already answered. Yes, short, very good. Erysias, Goic for short, yes, yes. So for Goic for short, the requirement on weekly is magenta color, weekly backdrop candle, which is true. In daily, it is already having lower high, lower low, price came up, tilted down with a magenta flow and also broke the memory support. Stop will be just above recent high, profit could be booked at the lower boundary, which also has the memory support and the ascending yellow line. We have acceptable reward risk ratio. So this is a Goic flow short candidate. You could run the sonar on this symbol and XLP would have come out. The sonar identifies the stocks with magenta or cyan candle and added some more criteria from the Goic flow checklist. So this would have come up in sonar as well. So we can find like that XLP, which has liquid option. And of course the ETF itself is liquid. It can be traded as a short trade. In fact, those who ran sonar using real-time data just before market close on Friday, superior profit guideline is it is better to enter at the close of the day itself, just before market close, not during the day, just before market close. So this is a trade we identified from sonar. Why sometimes I go to trade station, it is very fast to look at the stocks. So let me look at, there are two candidates I can see with stretch release in TradeStation. Let us look at them. One is XRT, the retail ETF. Now, if I change that template to At a Glance Advanced, then the stretch release signal will come. Now, see here. Again, interesting things using the effective Q signals. After the bullish headwind signal came, price went up. That was a very profitable swing trade. That's why we are always keeping an eye on the memory line, on the traffic slide, on the magenta candle, on the headwind, etc. Now, at the right edge, it has a stretch release signal, bear release. Weekly candle color is yellow. So that allows the short trade, stretch release trade. Only requirement is that daily candle had to be yellow also for a stretch release trade, bear release trade. That hasn't happened yet. So again, one could identify it using daily chart. Also weekly, you can say, because daily weekly was coming down from the resistance memory. So one could identify it, but not enter it on Friday because the candle color was green. But on Monday, if it goes below early range low, one could take a potential day trade. And if the day trade is profitable, one may book some profit and hold some as a swing trade. Just again, same as we did for gold and oil last week. Let's look at the one last symbol. That was showing stretch release. That is this symbol, XLK. Here again, we see that there is a bear release on the daily chart. Weekly is actually magenta. Weekly is magenta. So again, if it goes down, it may give a potential very low risk short opportunity using bear release, not a standard setup. In a standard setup, we will be happier if price broke above the watermark and tilted down. Then we'll be more happy. Here, price didn't quite reach it, so we are not that excited about it. But if on Monday price goes below, in fine-tune real-time chart, we may think of taking a day trade short. So we looked at all the topics that we wanted to cover. We looked at USA market, few international markets, some forex pairs, looked at all the trades that were posted in community since last class, and also looked at some real life market opportunities for next week. That is all I plan to share in this session. It is always a pleasure to meet you in this weekly market roundup. Thank you for taking time to join. And I look forward to seeing you soon in our next webinar.